Hello everybody and welcome back to Screen Stars and welcome to another PlayStation 4 review. And today I am reviewing Assassin's Creed 3 Remastered. This has just got its remastered release on the PlayStation 4 as well as other consoles. And this is a game that I played originally when it was first released back in 2012 on the PlayStation 3. I played it originally. And at the time, and for a few years following, this was my favourite Assassin's Creed game. It wasn't overly well received when it was released. I think, if I seem to remember, the reviews at the time where a lot of people complained that they thought Connor lacked personality, who was like the main character in this game. That was a main criticism, and they felt like they hadn't advanced the series on enough, etc. But everybody universally loved like the new ship combat and stuff that they'd added into the game this time round. So there were lots of hits and misses, and it was reasonably well received, but I do remember it getting some critique at the time. However, like I say, this was my favourite Assassin's Creed game for quite some time. What I really liked about this Assassin's Creed was the story, and I think it's probably, arguably, still my favourite story in the Assassin's Creed universe. If you've never played the Assassin's Creed 3 game, there's going to be some minor spoilers here on the story, but nothing major. I remember playing it for the first time, and you start the game off as this character called Haman. And for the first couple of hours, sort of thing, you play as this character, and I thought initially that he was going to be like the main character of this game, and I was really getting into this story and what he was doing and these little ploys they were getting up to, getting into it, and then it completely shifts the story to like the native Indian, and you star as Connor in this game, and he is a native American who is the child of this Haman who you meet at the beginning of the game, and he has been wronged by the Templars, and he is determined to put things right. He leaves his encampment to train as an assassin, heads off, gets some tips of where to go, and over a period of time he is trained up to become an assassin. The clips that you see, the majority of this game, is me not wearing the costume that you wear initially in the game. I'm actually wearing the Aguilar costume from the Assassin's Creed game, as you get loads of downloadable costumes that you can add to the character in this game. So that's the costume that you see here on screen is not the costume that you start with, just so you know. So you end up becoming an assassin, Connor, this Native American who is on a mission to take out these Templars who have wronged his people and wronged his tribe. Typical Assassin's Creed fashion, you go through them one at a time, taking down one at a time. And this is set in the backdrop of like the American Revolution. You've got your George Washington, all this rich American history going on around you. And that's what I really liked about this. It's set in Boston. The city's really, really beautifully realised. And I really, really enjoyed the story for the most part. Now, what have they done to this game in regards to the remaster? Because sometimes games get remastered and you play them and you just think, I can't really tell any difference here. Now, with this game, I think there's some of that. Some of the graphics, for the most part, have had an overhaul in the sense of the wilderness, the wildlife and the city and the buildings all look better. The character models in-game look better, however, some of the character models in the cutscenes look absolutely shocking. I mean, literally, they look like they've had their head caved in with a frying pan, some of them. They're really, really shocking character models. It looks a bit brighter, more colourful. So it's definitely had a graphical overhaul from the first game, from the original game in 2012. However, when you compare it to the modern-day Assassin's Creed, like Odyssey, etc., there is no comparison. Those are just vastly superior graphically than this. But it holds up well, and it looks pretty damn good for a remastered version. Now, they have revamped certain aspects of the game for the remaster. You get all the DLC with it, so you get Liberation with it, and some other parts of the DLC. Nothing major. And they've also added in some sneaking elements, some stealth elements to the game that weren't there before. So you're now able to hide in bushes and whistle for people to come over, and you can attract them and assassinate them silently, which apparently you couldn't do in the original one back in 2012. Now I don't remember, it's so long since I played that one, and it seems such a established mechanic in the series. I don't remember it not being in there originally, but apparently it wasn't. The combat, I think, is really cool. I've always liked the combat in the Assassin's Creed games, and they just perfected it, I think, from this game onwards. And now they've gone down a different route with the new games, as you've seen with Origins and Odyssey. They've gone for a more action-orientated mechanic in regards to the combat, which is fine, it works well, but I've got to say I really loved the counter system in these games, where you can, like, counter a move, and then you do like a you take them out with this vicious blow and stuff, and it just looks so cool. And I think I really like it in this game. It works really well. You've got your swords, you've got your tomahawks, you've got your, native Indian clubs, you've got your flint, your guns, you've got your bow and arrow, your darts. You've got all these mechanics going in here, so you've got a rich variety of weapons to take bad guys out with. None of that's changed. You can call in other people to assassinate people in crowds. All that stuff is going on now. If you're a fan of the earlier Assassin's Creed games, 1, 2, Revelations and Assassin's Creed 3, Black Flag, and even the more modern ones, Syndicate, etc. All the systems are in there that you remember, and it feels very familiar to you. And what I really liked about playing this is picking it up. It felt so familiar, because, like I said, the last 2 or 3 years we've played these updated versions of Assassin's Creed, and I do prefer them. I'll be honest, I absolutely adored Origins and Odyssey. Absolutely loved them, and there's reviews up on the channel for them both if you want to see them. But there's something to be said for these. They feel classic. They feel classic. They fit like a glove when you start playing them. You remember them so well. You remember all the mechanics and systems. But the negatives here are, it's got that classic Ubisoft littering maps with pointless things to do, like collecting feathers, collecting pages, that blowing in the wind, and all that stuff gets on my nerves. And the trinkets that you have to collect, and it's just really boring. It's pointless collecting for no real reason. So you've got the main thing this game has going for it is you've got your main missions that progress the story that I think are pretty good, and you've got what are called homestead missions, which are very. I begrudge calling them side quests, because they're not really side quests, because they're over very quickly. They're just quick missions that enable you to help people in your homestead, do a little mission for them, and then it enables them to craft better materials for you, like level 1, level 2, level 3, all that kind of stuff. So you can do all them sort of things in this game. You can craft new materials, you can enter the economic system if you want and send materials off here, there, and everywhere. But it's not overly interesting, any of it really, to be honest. Go around collecting treasure so you can buy better equipment in the stores, all that kind of stuff. Very familiar stuff, as you will all remember from playing the earlier Assassin's Creed games. But I have to say, when I knew that this was being remastered and released, I was quite looking forward to it, because, like I say, it's a personal favourite of mine, Assassin's Creed 3. I do really enjoy the story. I enjoyed at the time the new mechanics they put into the systems, like the ship combat, which is we're all very familiar with it, but at the time it was really cool and really new and revolutionary, and it worked really well, and it's been perfected since then in all the games since. And this game does have so much, an awful lot going for it. Like I said, a lot of people do complain that they think Connor's lacks personality. From my perspective, I thought he worked well. I thought he worked fine. When you actually analyse the story that he's in, I mean, his whole life, him and his people have been wronged. You know, seriously wronged. So he ain't going to be a jolly character like Jacob Fry in Syndicate, who's always cracking jokes. And some other characters who, you know, make fun and have a laugh. He's got nothing to have a laugh about, Connor, basically, in this game. And it's not a light subject. But I thought they handled the historical part of this game really, really well. And I learned a lot, and many people probably did learn a lot from the history of this game. I think it's one thing that Ubisoft do well, is they really work hard on getting the historical stuff as rich and interesting as they can in all the Assassin's Creed games. And I do applaud them for that. So I would say, if you've never played Assassin's Creed 3, and you're a fan of, certainly, and you've only played like maybe Odyssey or Origins, and you like Assassin's Creed, and that's what's got you into the series, then I would suggest that you pick up the earlier Assassin's Creed games and learn about how the earlier games were developed and made, and how it's grown as a series since Assassin's Creed 3. It started losing its way, some would argue from this game onwards, but they have, as I say, I still like this game. And they pretty much nailed it with Black Flag, and then they kind of lost their way a bit, even though I enjoyed Syndicate as well. So I think every Assassin's Creed game, you could argue, has got a certain level of quality to it, even if they refused to like update many of the mechanics for many years until they got to Origins. So definitely, if you've never played Assassin's Creed before, the remastered version is worth picking up. It's not full price. I paid $29.99 for it. And I would imagine if you wait a couple of months, you'll get it for, I don't know, maybe $19.99 or even cheaper than that in a sale. So I would suggest, if you're a little bit like that, pick it up in a sale when it comes out, when it drops down in price in a couple of months. So as it stands right now, as a game for the price it's on at, I will give this game an 8 out of 10. It is certainly worth playing and picking up. It's a lot of fun, great story, and there's some really fun elements to the game, and the combat works really well too. So there you go, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time on Screen Stars.